Hello everyone. Today, with the help of a simple demonstration with basketball and a tennis ball, we will see that how transfer of momentum takes place. So for that, let's see that what is happening now. If we draw a basketball from this height, you see the height it bounces back. Similarly, if I place these two balls together and drop it from the same height, we will see the how it bounces back. Now, place this tennis ball over the basketball and see what happens when you are dropping it from the same height. Can you observe the difference in a height previous and now? So now, why it happens? Let's see. We've already learned about the NLMs, like Newton's laws of motion. In that, we have studied a term called momentum. Momentum is actually the measure of motion, which depends upon mass and the velocity. In physics, we say P equals to mass multiplied by velocity, and P is the momentum over there. Now, the experiment or the demonstration I have shown you right now, you can see the difference in the height of a ball when that tennis ball is kept over the basket. In the first case, shall I show you again? In the first case, you see the height of the ball. It bounces back. This is the height. Now, in second case, you see the height of basketball, it bounces back. You can see in the second time, there is a loss in the height. Why is it so? It is because the transfer of momentum takes place from basketball into the tennis ball. Since the mass of the tennis ball is small, velocity is high, and therefore it goes to a higher height. So I hope you will understand how transfer of momentum takes place.